my mind kind of emptied out. I had played three sets of pretty hard mixed doubles tennis the day before and it, you know, survived, made it through. We had won. And I thought, oh, well, you know, I can't be that sick. You get tired very easily. I thought I was just headed towards middle age and in stressful situations. Then it was more than that. You know, everything seemed to be status quo, except he noticed on my right side a swelling in my neck area. I had a biopsy, and that day, that Monday morning, I went in. They said, yeah, it's cancerous.
An unusual form of thyroid cancer, which was, it's called medullary thyroid cancer. It's about 5% of all thyroid cancers. He looked like he had pretty advanced disease.
I think I had surgery within a week of the diagnosis.
Operated on him and tried to take out all the disease that we could and try to spare all of the important structures in his neck.
I remember going into surgery and just figuring I'm going to find out that there's more to this. And I remember Ray coming in and saying, look, according to everything we've tested you on, it does not look like it's spread outside the neck.
We were very fortunate in that after surgery, his calcitonin levels went down to zero and have stayed that way after 3 years, which is actually quite remarkable. That you know, right now he's disease free.
But I think I was especially lucky because of the quality of life improvement was pretty dramatic from the word go. 2 or 3 weeks after surgery, I think I played some tennis.
These lumps often have no symptoms. They're just there. And because they have no symptoms, people tend to ignore it. And that's a mistake.
And so I think I rationalized a lot instead of maybe listening and to my body a little bit more.
I'm glad that he has done well. Right. You know, he's had a good outcome. I mean, it doesn't happen every single time, but I'm happy for him.
Great assistance, incredibly professional, but personal.
Life-saving.
Hope so, yeah.